So ever since I announced my Lightroom Everywhere course, which will teach you how to use the cloud-based version of Lightroom across all your devices, link in the description below, I've gotten some questions in terms of the differences and the similarities between them. So questions like, what can I do on the desktop that I can't do on the iPad? And that is actually a very important question, and it's what I want to cover in this video. So I'm going to show you five of the, I would say, most applicable or important things that you can do on Lightroom on your desktop, but they are not available on Lightroom for mobile devices. The first feature that's available for Lightroom on the desktop only is stacking. So stacking is when you would group two or more photos together. Let's say you have, say, a bunch of photos that are kind of similar and you don't want them cluttering up your grid view. Well, what you can do is take them, press Shift and select them, and then you can right click and then go to group into stack, or you can press Command G on Mac or Control G on PC. When you do that, you'll see now that you have one thumbnail, and on the top right, you'll see there is a little badge with the number 7. That number will indicate how many photos are in that stack. And if I click on that little badge, you'll see a film strip appear with all of the photos there. And if you double click on the image, you can arrow through to see them. Now let me switch to the iPad, and you can see I have the exact same photo library here, but those photos that I just grouped into stacks does not migrate here. So there is no stacking functionality. Not only can you not stack or unstack, but you can't even view stacks that were created on the desktop. There is other metadata that will flow through. As you can see, my 4-star ratings go through. And if I apply a pick or reject flag, that will sync between devices. But stacking is just not available on mobile. And really, I hope Adobe brings parity between desktop and Lightroom for all of these features that I'm going to discuss in this video. All right, back to the desktop. So here I've got this photo, and you can see if I have the info view, there is no geotag information, but there are fields available. Now, if your camera has GPS functionality, or if you're connecting your camera to your phone, for example, to write the GPS data, that will appear here. But you can also manually add things. So here, I know this photo was taken in Staten Island, so I'm just going to type Staten Island, and then the state is New York, and the country is USA. If I click out and then click back in, you'll see that Lightroom has taken that information and added a map view, which is really cool. And now if we switch to the iPad and I go to that same photo, in the info view, you'll see that not only do we not see the geotag information that we added, we don't see anything. So on the iPad and the iPhone, you cannot add or view any sort of geotagged information. Now, I'm not exactly sure why this functionality is not available on the iPhone and the iPad. It seems like a no-cost addition that Adobe could add and just adds more value and functionality for its users. Again, maybe we'll see it in the future. Now, there is another set of features on the desktop that I've been begging Adobe for years, and that is Photo Merge. So Photo Merge is a collection of three functions. If I go to this folder here, those three functions are HDR, Pano, and HDR Pano. So you can imagine how many photographers, especially on the iPad, may want to combine multiple bracketed photos into a new tone mapped HDR image. On the desktop, all you need to do is select the images, right click, go to Photo Merge, and then select HDR Merge. Or if it was a Pano, you would select that. And if it's an HDR Pano, you would select that. Point is that this functionality is available on the desktop only. And if you're working on the iPad, you won't see that functionality at all. It's not available on the mobile version of Lightroom. And I don't know why, because for the most part, especially if you are actively using Cloud Sync for all of your original files, your original RAW files are already in Adobe's cloud server. So to be able to execute a tone map or a panel stitch should be also a very low cost thing that could be done in the cloud. And then that file, that stitched file or that tone map file would be delivered to you locally, but it's not available. However, if I were to take these three files and do an HDR merge, that merged file would sync to the cloud and be available on all of my devices. Now, over the past year, year and a half, Adobe has been doing some great things by adding AI-powered tools to Lightroom, things like the new Denoise AI and Super Resolution. Those things, unfortunately, are also desktop only. You don't have access to that on the iPad, so let me show you what I mean. And like I mentioned, a couple months ago, Adobe released their new Denoise AI filter, which is really amazing, and I've got a video covering that. All you need to do is right click on the photo and then go to enhance, and you'll have this dialog box with a few options. So here you can apply the AI denoise as well as raw detail, or you can deselect denoise and apply a 4x super resolution upscale. However, This stuff is only available on the desktop. And with the exception of super resolution, denoise and raw details currently only work with raw or certain DNG files. And that's kind of a shame because as you can see here, if I enable denoise, the results are absolutely fantastic. Now, like with the photo merge examples, if I were to apply denoise AI to this photo, for example, and a new DNG file is created, that DNG file will get synced to the cloud and be made available on all devices so that you can edit them and share them regardless of what you're using. And the fifth and final difference between Lightroom Desktop and the mobile devices that I think will affect a lot of photographers is the availability of specific masking tools. Now, I'll be the first to admit that Lightroom has been doing absolutely amazing things with their adaptive masks. The fact that you can select the sky from image to image and Lightroom will just know where the sky is on the desktop or mobile is really impressive. However, there are some really powerful tools on the desktop for masking that aren't yet available on mobile. The first one that's missing from mobile, I will admit, is not super important, and that is background. To be honest, background is basically the select subject masking, and then it's inverted. And you can even see it with the icon. Like here is the subject icon, and then background is the subject inverted. Now, I won't ding Adobe so much for this because on the iPad, you can kind of replicate the background selection. All you need to do is tap on select subject and then swipe out over here and tap invert. And that is effectively select background. So the fact that it's not on mobile is no big loss. But switching to the desktop over here, what is missing is the object selection tool. And this is a shame because it is so powerful. All I need to do is go here, and then I have one of two selection options. I can either use a brush and just draw on what I want selected, and you can see the selection is made beautifully, or I can just use the rectangle marquee tool and make a selection around the person and get that same really clean selection. But if you switch to the iPad or the iPhone, it's not all doom and gloom because if you go to that photo here and then you go to the mask view, you'll see that the mask that you saved will sync over, even if you use tools that are not available on mobile, like object selection. Now, since we're talking about the differences in masking tools between Lightroom on the desktop and mobile, I've got one more for you. In Lightroom on desktop, if you go to create a new mask, there is this people option, and that is not available on mobile devices, which is unfortunate because it's really powerful. If you open up a portrait photo, Lightroom will detect the different people. If you click on an individual, you have the option to create these individualized masks for the person. Now, I already went ahead and created some masks here, which you can see right here. I named this girl Betty, and I selected a mask for her hair and for the skin on her face. Now, the silver lining is that if we switch to the iPad here and we open that same photo and go to the masking view here, you'll see those masks that we created on the desktop using the AI-powered people view are available for you here so you can edit them on any device. And so, like I said, those are a handful of differences between the Lightroom on the desktop and Lightroom on the iPad. Same kind of goes with Lightroom Classic users. Pretty much everything I showed you for Lightroom on the desktop is available on Classic, so this applies to you as well. Now, again, if you're interested in learning everything there is to know about using Lightroom's cloud-based ecosystem, I would love it if you checked out my new course, Lightroom Everywhere. Again, link is in the description below. If you want to learn more about denoise AI in Lightroom, check out this video. And if this video was helpful for you, a thumbs up will help, as well as subscribing and clicking on the bell icon. Thanks a lot, everyone.